which is quite a Masonic story. Of course, we're the Freemason. What we don't know is that very humorously, Mozart is known to be joking as follows. What is worse than one flute? Two flutes. And then, of course, he writes an opera about it. He also, curiously, influenced a great deal of young adults of today. Because in the 90s, which is when we were babies, it was known as the Mozart effect. There was a study that said that if a child was exposed to listening to Mozart's specific piece, to pianos not in D, they would have better spatial capacities, grown-ups, and essentially have a better brain. So there were many CDs made Mozart for babies, and a lot of us were listening to it, whether or not we remember that or chose to do it. And hopefully it will also contribute to our better spatial awareness today, as we're going to hear the variations called The Woman is a Wonderful Thing that Leo is going to play for us.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
for Vladimir Putin's, the Russian seasons, that Empresario Diaghilev really put composers such as Stravinsky on that wave. And Petrushka is the third and wildly successful ballet, the triptych of ballets that was composed by Stravinsky for Diaghilev, which are Firebird, The Rite of Spring, and Petrushka. Unsurprisingly, it does follow the Russian folk story, in which Petrushka is a sort of a hay doll, kind of a not so fortunate guy who is terribly, terribly in love with the ballerina, who is more interested in the Moor, who is very attractive and not very smart. Apparently, the Moor, here's the fun fact, couldn't crack a coconut with his sword, so he decided coconut was a god and worshipped him. Or rather, it. Now, of course, Petrushka eventually has a duel with him and dies and pretends he's a ghost. So it's kind of a grisly story. But the moments that we're hearing today also take place in the Russian equivalent of Mardi Gras. So what you're going to hear is a tremendous amount of people gathered celebrating things. And of course, there's a theme of Petrushka, his jealousy, the Moor, and the ballerina. There is a specific sonority that is known as a Petrushka chord. And it is basically at the same time in two different keys. One is this, and the other one is this. They happen to be a tritone apart, which was in Western music for many hundreds of years considered the devil's interval. How do you with that? much like the overture of the opera. Here, the main music is played immediately by the soloist, putting the, therefore, pianist in the foreground of the experience, and then the orchestra sort of repeats it. He also is lionized these days as this man against God and against destiny kind of figure who composed, as he had, music that was embodying that sort of self-actualization of the Romantic Age. But he was a man of real world and of many an indulgence.